Hey girls, it's Steph here.
And Esther, and this is just a little reminder that
we are doing some re-airs for the next few months, and this episode is a re-air. So you might have listened to it, or you might have not.
And we're doing re-airs so that we can prepare new content for the podcast.
Yes, it's really exciting. We can't wait. So make sure that, you do sign up to our newsletter so you can get all the inside news of what's happening.
Yes. So enjoy the program. Bye.
Bye.
You're listening to GIGI Radio,
the one and only Christian radio show for teen girls,
with your hosts, Esther and Steph. Obsessed. Audrey scrolled through her phone for what seemed the 100th time and frowned. Why hadn't a crush messaged back? It had been 2 hours and he hadn't replied to the text she sent. Maybe he hated her and didn't like her anymore. Panic seized her heart. What would she do if he liked someone else? Maybe he was in love with a new girl at school, that stunning, blonde, tall Elizabeth Harrison. Not fair, Audrey whispered as angry tears threatened to fall. She tossed her phone across her bed and stormed out. The house was quiet. Her dad and brother had gone camping for the weekend, and she was home alone with Mum. Her mum was sitting outside in the sun reading a book. Audrey looked around, trying to see what she could do to distract her mind. The kitchen. She fumbled through the pantry, looking for something salty to munch on. She came across a packet of salt and vinegar chips. She tore the packet open and popped a salty, tangy deliciousness in her mouth. It was good. Her mind traveled to Eric, the guy she was completely in love with. She saved photos from the school's social media sites and kept them hidden in her phone. As often as she could, she would sneak a look and stare at his gorgeous face and hot body. She wished she could date him. They were in the same grade and friends, but he didn't know she had a major crush on him. What could she do? How could she grab his attention and show him that she was the one for him? But now, who knows if that would happen? Ever since the new girl had come to school this term, he had been a little less chatty with Audrey. He seemed to be talking to her quite a bit, though. Feeling mad, Audrey stuffed a few pieces of chips into her mouth and crunched away deep in thought. Maybe she should just tell him how much she liked him. That might grab his attention. Or maybe she should bake and take chocolate chip cookies for him and her friends. Yes, that sounded perfect. In the distance, she heard her phone ding, announcing the arrival of a text message. She dropped her chips and bolted to her room to see what the message read. She hoped it was Eric finally replying. The little green light on the side of her phone indicated that she had a new message. With trembling fingers, she unlocked her phone and saw the message was from him. A huge grin danced on her lips and she happily replied. Feeling happy and on top of the world, Audrey headed to the kitchen to start baking those cookies. For the next hour, she was busy measuring, melting, mixing and beating, her favorite artist blaring in the background as she cooked. "It smells delicious, honey." The shout near her ear made her jump. She hadn't even heard her mother come in. Audrey giggled. "Thanks, Ma." She wiped one sticky finger on her apron, stopped the music on her phone. "What's the occasion?" her mother asked, opening the fridge and taking the orange juice out. "Just baking for my friends." Audrey smiled, trying to avoid her mother's stare. "Friends like?" her mother pressed. "You know, Jess, Liz, Mike, Sam." Audrey licked a sticky finger and headed to the tap to wash her hands. "What?" she demanded, seeing the look her mum was giving her. "Is Eric included in that friend list?" Her mother took a sip of juice from her glass and lifted one eyebrow. "Yes, sir." Audrey could feel her temper rising. "Honey, I thought you were over him," her mother began. Audrey turned the tap a little too strongly and water gushed out, splashing her. Her mother kept on talking. "You were a little happier before this boy invaded all your thoughts." Her mother placed the juice back in the fridge. "I just want my happy, God-loving girl back." Her mum rubbed her back briefly and headed out the back door again. Audrey stared at the water gushing out of the tap and felt tears falling down her cheeks. She was so sad. She wished her mum wasn't right, but she was. She was obsessed with Eric and he invaded all of her thoughts. And what did her mum mean about wanting her happy, God-loving girl back? She still loved God, didn't she? Actually, When was the last time she had actually talked to him? Leaning into her arms, Audrey cried for a long while. She wished she wasn't so miserable. She wished her happiness didn't depend on Eric. The blaring sound of the fire alarm brought her back to reality as she saw and smelled smoke coming from the oven. Her cook is burnt, but she didn't care. She needed to have a good chat with God.
Matthew chapter 22 verse 37 says, "And he said to him, you shall love the Lord your God with all your heart and with all your soul and with all your mind." Oh, that's really sad. I do feel her pain. Girls, we've all been there. Okay, I wasn't completely full on stalker that kept photos. But yeah, you sometimes do get caught up in that. He looked at me. He smiled at me today. Oh my goodness. I know. He sat next to me. He actually bumped me. Woohoo!
Did he look at me? Is he looking at me? Is he coming this way? I remember. What I find really sad about Audrey is that her whole, you know, essence of happiness depended on this guy, Eric. It's not Eric's fault.
No, it actually isn't.
You know, we make it our own problem.
We do become obsessive, don't we? Girls, what's wrong with us? We become obsessive.
But is it a big deal?
I think the other sad thing is, or interesting thing, she didn't even notice she hadn't talked to God.
But is that a big deal?
Is it? Let's come back after this song. So it is still Leanna Crawford and Truth I'm Standing On.
Scared. Oh, I thought I knew scared. But I'm so filled with fear, I can barely move. Doubt, I've had my share of doubt, but never more than right now. I'm wondering, where are you? Here on the edge of fall. Somehow your promises find my troubled heart. This is the truth I'm saying.
So we were discussing whether it's a big deal to, have a guy invade all our thoughts. And I found a verse that I really, really loved. We did Deuteronomy 6:5.
Yeah, we've done that one.
Yeah, that says, love the Lord your God with all your heart and with all your soul and with all your strength. But the Message version is quite beautiful as well. And I wanted to share that one. It says, love God, your God, with all your whole heart. Love him with all that's in you. Love him with all you've got.
Oh, that is nice. I love that. That's why I like looking at different versions, just to see what they have.
Yes.
So it is really sad. And, you know, when we love someone more than God, then that is an idol.
Mm.
You know, how many times a day do you like look or scroll or think about a crush? Do you save a photo of a cute singer or an actor that you might admire? These photos, are they a little bit
risque,
shirtless?
Yes.
You know, half a body, is it only the face, or is it a bit more? You know, what are you keeping on your phone?
And how many times a day do you peek at those throughout the day? Like, think about those. Those are good things to
reflect on.
And can I just ask this? What kind of feelings do they evoke in you when you see these images, either of your crush or your actors and singers crush? You know, think of the feelings that come in your belly or your heart races, or you just feel, ooh, you know, things that maybe shouldn't be feeling.
Exactly. And do you actually keep photos of Jesus on your phone?
Or quotes? And do you flip these throughout the day and be inspired by them?
Do you, girls?
Girls, you know, this is something that as women, us, and that we fail as well. How many times a day do I go on my phone and do I look at a picture of Jesus or look at a quote?
We don't.
It's something that we don't practice. I think most of the times we scroll on social media and we're looking at other things, but not at God.
Yeah, and I think also the people or the accounts or whatever it is called that you're following, you know, are they inspiring you or are they also doing, you know, discouraging you or feeding this crush or these strange obsessions that you should probably not be feeling,
yes,
at the moment.
So liking someone, girls, is not a sin. You know, God did that. He created Adam and Eve to love each other. So that's not a sin. But when your whole happiness depends on this guy or this relationship, then that's when you have to be
careful. And sort of get that little antenna, little radar saying, oh, wait, something's not right here. You know, what's happening? And also, apart from them consuming like your thoughts, your pictures, whatever, your phone, also, what are you thinking about them during the day? Are you thinking that you're kissing them? Are you thinking that you're holding hands? Like, also, those thoughts are not healthy and they're not good. So, yeah, liking someone, normal. But then the other thoughts and the obsession are the ones that you need to be like really, really careful with.
That's right. So our happiness should come from the Lord completely, from being in his word, for talking to him in prayer. And, you know, God wants us to be completely happy.
And with peace. And girls, it doesn't matter if you do end up dating the hot guy from school or from uni or wherever, from work. He will actually not make you happy like you think he will, because your happiness comes from God.
You have to be whole in God first, in Jesus first, and then everything else will fulfill.
And I've probably, and I've said this before, a guy, a relationship will never complete you.
Mm-hmm.
He can't complete you. He can compliment you, but you have to be completed and whole in God before you can be happy.
Now, for you to fall in love with Jesus more, we have three little things. Well, I don't know if it's three, but a few little things you can do. Number one. All you have to do is study his word daily. So getting into the Bible devotional daily.
Yeah.
Next one, you have to pray to him. That's chatting with God. I mean, you can't email him, text him, but you can talk to him in your mind or out loud, however you want. And the third one is thinking about him all day, either with Bible verses or just thinking, well, God has done this for me. It's amazing.
I always like to try and work on the like memory verse for learning. Use that, you know, work on that for the week when you're feeling or you have those strange thoughts or things like that. Go back and look up the verse and think, okay, and start going through it and let God be the one who fills your thoughts, your mind, your heart.
And you will notice that God will fill you with peace and he will fill you with joy.
Yeah, happiness.
Serenity.
Mm-hmm.
And he will never leave you and forsake you.
Or betray you. You can trust him 100% in every area of your life.
That's right. Let's pray. Dear Lord, thank you for a new day. Thank you that we can start the morning with you. Today, I ask a special prayer for each of our listeners. May you bless their heart. May you fill them with peace and help them with anything that they're struggling with or consuming their minds, and help them let that go. I ask, Lord, to shine your light on our beautiful girls, and they can shine it to others. In your precious name, I ask. Amen.
This has been GIGI Radio signing out.